Hi, hello, namaste. Welcome back to Needs of Children. In this video, we are going to get the information about 10th Standard English Medium Social Science History Chapter Number 1, Advent of Europeans to India. Let's come to the what are the very important learning points from the lesson Advent of Europeans to India. In this unit, you learn the trade and commerce relationship India had with Europeans. The arrival of Europeans to India for trade. The Carnatic Wars in the backdrop of European political developments. Battle of Plassey, Battle of Buxar and dual government system. The British policy of aggression. So, let's come to the introduction for the lesson Advent of Europeans to India. Trade relationship between India and Europe. So there were trade and commerce relationship between India and Europe since ancient times. It is not a new one, from the ancient times. That means when civilizations were flourished, from there onwards there is a trade link between India and European countries. As our Indian products, Indian spices were great demand in European market. Among that, the Indian spices like pepper, cardamom, ginger and many other spices, they were great demand in European markets. So as a result, the trade relationship continued between India, Europe and other Asian countries even during the time of the Middle Ages. The Arab merchants carried the Asian merchandise into Constantinople of Eastern Roman Empire. It is also known as the Byzantium Empire. So usually they are taking the goods. Arab merchants will carry the goods from the Asian merchandise into the Constantinople of Eastern Roman Empire, and from there they are supplying to European markets. With this, in the Europe, Italian merchants, they will buy these goods from the Arab merchants and they will sell in the European countries. Like this, Constantinople was become the center of international business and considered as the gate of European trade. So that Constantinople is become the gate of European trade between Europe and Asia. While Arab merchants had gained monopoly over the trade in Asian countries because of their work as link between Europe and Asian countries. In the other hand, in Europe, Italian traders had gained the monopoly over the trade in Europe. So here, Arabs in Europe, Italians, they gained the monopoly. So that the merchandise from Asia had brought good profits to Italian merchants. The reasons for the discovery of new sea route to India. The concept of the fall of Constantinople. As the trade and commerce between Asia and Europe was taking place through the city of Constantinople. The Constantinople, which was conquered by, captured by Ottoman Turks in 1453. As a result of this, all trade routes connecting the city of Constantinople came under the control of the Turks. Thus, the Turks started levying too many taxes on the goods passing through the routes, because Constantinople, it was the only route which is connecting between Asia and Europe. It was the only route, sea route as well as land route. So, when Constantinople was captured by Ottoman Turks, they started levying too many taxes on the goods which are passing through the routes. So, as a result of this, the merchants felt that trade was not profitable. So, either Arab traders as well as Italian traders, merchandise or merchants, they felt the trade, it was not a profitable. So, meanwhile, the Spain and Portugal. So, what you are seeing in the yellow in color, it is a Portugal, and this green in color, it is Spain, and this red in color, Italian places. They were attempting to break the monopoly of the Italian traders, because Spain and Portugal, they were observed how Italian traders are getting the profit. They started encouraging courageous sailors to find out the sea routes to India. They have to connect India at any cost from the other routes. That is the reason Spain and Portugal, they are trying to encouraging find out the new sea routes to India. So that the invention of compass, astrolabe and gunpowder provided future importance for this discovery of new sea routes to India. So finally, what they are having the dream of find out new sea routes to India. It was came into existed with the help of the Portuguese sailor name called as Vasco da Gama. So left the Lisbon and reached the Kappadu near Calicut on the east coast of India in 1498. By this, he was successful in discovering new sea routes to India. So, finally, what this route continued to be the route of trade between India and Europe for many years. The dream of Europeans, it is come to true with the help of Vasco da Gama. What they are struggling to find out the alternative sea routes to India, it is came into existed with the help of Vasco da Gama. Like this, Portuguese were the first to re-establish trade between India and Europe, because when 1453 Constantinople was captured by the Ottoman Turks, the land and sea route, it is completely closed. But the closed trade once again re-established by Portuguese between India and Europe. By the way, in the year 1869, a huge canal was built in Egypt to connect the Red Sea and Mediterranean Sea, and it is called as the Suez Canal. Until the building of Suez Canal, the sea route discovered by the Vasco da Gama was the route used for the trade between India and Europe. The ships had to pass the Cape of Good Hope, the southernmost tip of Africa, to reach India. So about the discovering of new sea routes, the concept you have studied in 9th standard. So the distance between Mumbai and London through Cape of Good Hope is 10,800 nautical miles. So one nautical mile is equals to 1.85 kilometers. It is only 6,200 nautical miles through the Suez Canal. The journey is reduced to half of the distance. So this is some information about the Suez Canal, how it is find out after the sea route by Vasco da Gama. So let's come to the European trade companies to India. How the European trade companies, they established their East Indian companies, and how they started the trade, how it is went on. Among that, with the success of Portuguese, many like Dutch, French, English, they arrived at India for the purpose of trade. This development not only changed the history of India, it also changed the history of European countries. So the colored map, so you can identify, those are all considered as the European countries. They started trade in India. This was the trade not only changed the history of India, even it is changed the history of European countries. So who are the European trade companies? They started trade in India. Let's come to the, we are going to get one by one. Among that, Portuguese. Portuguese were the first to arrive at India for the trade and were also last to leave India on the sea route. So by the way, Vasco da Gama, he was first to reach India because he was find out the sea routes to India. After that, Vasco da Gama, Francisco de Almeida arrived in India as the Viceroy of Portuguese. When he was appointed as a Viceroy of Portuguese, he implemented Blue Water Policy. So according to this, he established the supremacy over the sea instead of supremacy over the land. So beginning of usually the land which is controlled under the people, but now it is come under the Blue Water Policy. They got supremacy over the sea instead of supremacy over lands. After Francisco de Almeida, the one more Viceroy of Portuguese, name called as Alfonso de Albuquerque, who came after Almeida, he was considered as the real founder of Portuguese Empire in India. He waged a battle against the Sultan of Bijapur in 1510 and won the place of Goa. So you can see the blinking mark in map. Then Goa became the administrative center for the Portuguese administration in India. The Portuguese had absolute monopoly, absolute dictatorship over the trade with India for almost a century, and their power declined with the arrival of English and French in India. Until so they have got the absolute monopoly over trade in India. So this is about the Portuguese. And the next, Dutch are from Holland or Netherlands. They established United East India Company in 1602 with the aim of doing business with Eastern countries, and entered countries like India, Java, Sumatra, Indonesia, and spices rich islands. They concentrated the islands which are rich in spices. And even they established warehouses in India like Surat, Brach, Bombay, Cochin, Nagapattinam, Masulipattinam and Chinsoor and in some other places in India. With this, they broke the monopoly of the Portuguese in India. So later, they are also unable to face the competition from English and French. So that Dutch limited themselves to spice rich islands. So this is about the Dutch. So here, warehouses, the meaning of warehouses were the places of storing merchandise. Huge walls were built around these warehouses to provide protection. Generally, we used to be called as godowns. Merchants usually what they are purchased the products, storing places called as warehouses. And the next one, European trade company, that is English. In 1600, December 31st, Queen Elizabeth issued a royal charter authorizing East India Company to trade with Eastern countries for 15 years. Queen Elizabeth given the permission to East India Company trade in India for the permission of 15 years on 1600 December 31st. So after this permission, the company started the business formally in 1613. They got the permission from 1600, but formally the company started business in the year 1613. So during that time, the Mughal Emperor Jahangir issued a royal permission to English to establish their first warehouse of factory at Surat. They got the permission from Mughal Emperor name called as Jahangir to establish their first warehouse factory at Surat. In the year 1617, Sir Thomas Rowe arrived at the court of Jahangir as the royal ambassador from the court of James I from the England. He sought the permission from Jahangir to establish factories in other places of Mughal Empire. So Jahangir, he gave, established the first factory at Surat. But in the year 1617, Sir Thomas Rowe, he came from England, sent by James I. He asked to Jahangir establish factories in other places of Mughal Empire. So, as a result of that, Mughal Empire gave the permission to establish English factories in Agra, Ahmedabad and Brooch. So, in 1639, English took Madras from the king of Chandragiri and established a strong fort name called as Saint George Fort. Later, Charles II, the Prince of England, gave Bombay as an annual rent of £10 a year to East India Company in 1668. Charles II, the Prince of England, he got Bombay as a gift from the Indian rulers. So he gave to the East India Company as an annual rent of £10 per year in the year 1668. So in the year 1690, the English purchased the three important villages, namely Sautanati, Kalikata and Govindapura on the banks of Hooghly River and built Fort William. They built a Fort William on Hooghly River. So the city of Calcutta grew around this fort. Around that fort, Calcutta city, it has been started growing. So later on, by the 17th century, the English had established Bombay, Madras and Calcutta as the centers of their presidencies, nothing but as a administrative centers. So what you are seeing in the map of blinking, those are all the places are considered as the Bombay, Madras and Calcutta. By the later part of 18th century, the English made Calcutta as their capital city. They implemented their own civil and criminal procedure courts in the area that were under their control. So like this, beginning of, they got only the one place like Surat from the Mughal Emperor Jahangir. But now, by the 17th century, half of the part of India, it was come under the control of the British. And the next, one more European trade company, that is French. French East India Company started as a government-owned company in 1664. It started its first factory in Surat in the year 1668. Later, they established its factories in Masalipattanam, Chandranagara, Mahe, Karaikallu, Kasim Bazar and Balasur. By the way, in the year 1674, the French took Valikanandapuram from local Muslim officials and they developed it as a major trade center. Later on, that center is today we are going to be called as Puducherry or Pondicherry. The earlier name of Puducherry or Pondicherry, it is called as Valikanandapuram. It was given by local Muslims to the French. So here, from the French side, Dupleix, who arrived in India, who arrived to Pondicherry as the Governor General of French, had the high ambitious of establishing French as the major power in South India. With the intention of that, he came to India. This ambition led to the Carnatic Wars with the English. So, how the competition between English and French, we are going to be discuss in next video. I hope you have understood these concepts. If you are having any doubts and clarifications, please comment in the comment box. So I will come back with the next video. Until, keep watching my channel. Thank you. See you in the next session. Bye bye.